Today we are discuss about properties of cosets. If H is any subgroup of capital G and A comma B belongs to G, then A belongs to AH, AH is equals to H if and only if A belongs to H, AH is equals to BH if and only if A belongs to BH. Fourth one, AH is equals to BH or AH, AH intersection BH is equals to pi. Nothing but the cosets are identical or disjoint. Next, fifth one, AH is equals to BH if and only if A inverse B belongs to H. Next, sixth one, modulus of AH, order of any left coset is equals to order of any, this is also left coset of H in capital G. Seventh one, AH is a subgroup of capital G if and only if A belongs to capital H. Eighth one, G is equals to union of AIH, nothing but G is the union of the distinct left or right cosets of H in G. Already in previous class, we have discussed about 192 properties. Now we have to go third property. What is the third property? AH is equals to BH if and only if A belongs to BH. Consider AH is equals to BH. What we have to prove that? A belongs to BH. By property 1, what is the property 1? A belongs to AH. A belongs to AH. But AH is equals to BH. So clearly A belongs to BH. This is the necessary part. Next we have to go to sufficient part. Consider A belongs to BH. What we have to prove that? AH is equals to BH. Since A belongs to BH, both sides multiplying with the B inverse. B inverse A into B inverse A belongs to B inverse BH. B inverse A belongs to B inverse B is equals to EH. We know that EH is equals to capital H. B inverse A belongs to capital H. What is the second property? A belongs to H if and only if AH is equals to H. B inverse A belongs to capital H. In place of A here, B inverse A. So B inverse A into H is equals to capital H. So both sides multiplying with the B. B into B inverse AH is equals to BH. EAH is equals to BH. Because B into B inverse is equals to small e. So AH is equals to BH. Next, very important one. Fifth one, AH is equals to. Fifth property. What is the fifth property? AH is equals to BH if and only if A inverse B belongs to capital H. First, consider. What is the consideration in fifth one? AH is equals to BH. What we have to prove that? A inverse B belongs to capital H. So, by one, A belongs to AH. Similarly, B belongs to BH. BH is equals to AH because it is our consideration. So, B belongs to AH. So, here A is there. So, both sides multiplying with A inverse. A inverse B belongs to capital H. So, this is completing the necessary part. Next, we have to go to sufficient part. Consider A inverse B belongs to capital H. What we have to prove that? AH is equals to BH. A inverse B belongs to capital H. So, by the second property, A belongs to H. If and only if AH is equals to AH, AH is equals to H. A inverse B, H is equals to H. Both sides multiply with the small a. A into A inverse BH is equals to AH. A into A inverse is equals to EBH is equals to AH. Implies BH is equals to AH. Very important one. Previous. This is the previous question. H is a subgroup of capital G, then AH is equals to BH if and only if A belongs to BH. This is the common. H is a subgroup of capital G. Necessary part, AH is equals to BH consideration. What we have to prove that? A belongs to BH. By the definition of the coset, A can be written as A into E belongs to AH. But what we have to consideration? AH is equals to BH. A belongs to BH. Sufficient part, consider A belongs to BH. What we have to prove that? AH is equals to BH. A belongs to BH, both sides multiplying with the B inverse A. B inverse A, B inverse. B inverse into A, B inverse into B. B inverse into B is equals to E. E into H is equals to H. So, implies B inverse A belongs to capital H. Same as second property. What is the second property? A belongs to H if and only if AH is equals to H is equals to HA. So belongs to becomes is equals to B inverse AH is equals to H, both sets multiplying with B. B into B inverse AH is equals to BH if implies AH is equals to BH. Now Lagrange's theorem. It is an important one. If G is a finite group, capital H is a subgroup of capital G, then order of H divides order of G. G is a finite group, let order of G is equals to N. And H is a subgroup of capital G, let order of H is equals to small m. What we have to prove? That order of H divides order of G. That is M divides N. By the property of the coset, what is the last property? G is the union of the left or right cosets of H in G. So G is equals to A1H, A2H and so on, union of AKH. So applying modulus A1H, union A2H, these are all the sets. Whenever applying modulus, it becomes modulus of G is equals to modulus of A1H, union becomes plus A2H and so on plus modulus of AKH. Implies order of G is equals to N. So order of A1H is equals to small m, because order of H is equals to order of A1H is equals to order of A2H is equals to order of and so on order of AKH. So m plus and so on k times, implies n is equals to mk. N by m is equals to k. K is an integer, so nothing but m divides n. That nothing but order of H divides order of G. Next very important theorem, a group of prime order is cyclic. Prime number, we know that the factors of the prime number is 1 and itself only. So let P greater than 2 be a prime number and G be a group of order such that order of G is equals to P. Nothing but the order of the group P, it is a prime number greater than or equal to 2. Let another group H, that is nothing but it is a cyclic group, is a subgroup of capital G generated by small a, because every cyclic group generated by the definition of the cyclic group, it is generated by some element. So clearly small a belongs to generated with A. So generated with A not equal to singleton set E, nothing but H does not contain single element. Let H is equals to generated with A of order small h. So modulus of H is equals to modulus of generator of A is equals to small h. Nothing but the order of the elements of capital H is small h. Already here generator of A is not equal to singleton set E. Nothing but H small h not equal to 1. What is the Lagrange's theorem? Order of H divides order of G. Order of H divides order of G. Small h divides P. But P is a prime number. What are the prime factors? 1 and itself. So H not equal to 1. But H not equal to 1. What is the possibility is there? H is equals to P. What is H? Order of the capital H. Order of generated with A is equals to. What is P? What is P? Number of elements of capital G. LHS is equals to RHS. Modulus of G is equals to modulus of generated with A. So implies G is equals to generated with A. So therefore G is a cyclic group.